everybody. Welcome to Keto-alicious. Today is my day 17. Can you believe it? It has been, it's gone by so fast, and I am so happy. I feel so good. I haven't gotten a lot of compliments yet because I have a lot of weight to lose. I'm looking to lose 80 pounds maybe or so. So I haven't gotten a lot of compliments, but I don't care about that. But my husband did make a comment, about, are you doing something different? You know, and I just kind of laugh. So it'll come. You know, every day is different, but I'm so excited that you guys are here today. I'm excited. I'd like to talk to you a little bit about if you were just starting the keto diet and you just were looking for some information, today is what I'm going to do with that. That is going to be my title today, is getting started. So if I were to say the very first thing that I would do, number one would be make sure that you get the knowledge as far as the foods that are keto friendly. Okay, and I have a video on that, and you're more than welcome to take a peek of that. I also have a free keto low carb food list that you're more than welcome to take a look at. Just I can put that link in the description if you'd like me to. Also, I would say number two, after you get the foods, I would say go through your cupboards, go through your refrigerator, especially if you're, you know, and it won't hurt for your family to eat healthier either. So get rid of anything that has flour, anything that has sugar, anything that has beans in it, anything that has pasta or any pastas, all of those, you know, you don't, and chips and anything sweet, anything that is going to tempt you to walk away from keto, get rid of it. And some people might say that's a waste. Give it to somebody else. But I would throw it away because I don't want to give what I know now with keto. I would not want to give it to my family, the sugar-laden foods. So, you know, if you're making a commitment, make a commitment. Do it or don't. You know, that's kind of my motto. Do it or don't. So anyway, so number three, after you've got the list of everything that you need to, that you're going to be eating, and after you've cleaned out your kitchen and you're free from the junk or the crap that you're going to keep you out of ketosis or out of the keto diet, the next thing I would say is have an amazing meal, fill your belly up, and then take yourself to the store and take your list. And I would also say maybe come up with about five recipes, keto recipes. And I have a lot of those to help you out if you like. You can use mine. You can alter yours, or you can, there's all kinds of places on the internet that you can find recipes. Grab five that maybe will be really good for you. And maybe, you know, pre-plan a little bit, maybe five lunches and five dinners. And for however many people you're cooking, if it's just yourself, and make yourself a list and stick with that list. Shop on the outside of the perimeters. Don't shop on the insides too much. You know, you can go up and down and look because you're always looking for new keto options, but have your belly full. Have water with you so that you're not starving when you go into the refrigerator or go into the grocery store. When you bring everything home, put it into proportion sizes and then freeze it that you're going to be cooking with. Or if you're going to be meal planning, then lay everything out and start making your recipes and have to-go boxes or containers that you can put in the freezer. Okay. The next thing I would say is if you don't like water, a lot of people say that. If you don't like water, then get some stevia, get some flavored stevia drops that you can put in. Do teas. There's Bai, I showed you that. There's Zevia, which is just like Pop. It's made with stevia. So there's all kinds of things that you can do. You don't just have to drink water. You know, you could drink carbonated bubbly water that's flavored, and you could drink Zevia, you know, and sometimes those are counted toward your water. So option it out a little bit, but you do need water. And I would recommend that you drink half of your body weight in water. And if you can't get it all in it in the beginning, that's okay. But just start. Drink it in the morning. Have one before your cup of coffee. Have one before your main meal. Have one before your snack. Have one before your dinner. Have two or three before at dinner times or after dinner so that you're not hungry, and you won't be hungry anyway. Now, a lot of people think you need to make three meals. That's okay if you want to do that. But I only eat two meals. And the reason I eat two meals is because I'm so full. I am full from my big meal that I start. I do intermittent fasting. So I start eating at 11 or 12, and then I stop at 7 or 8. And I don't eat again until I drink my coffee in the morning, and I have lemon water in the morning. And I don't eat anything until 11 or 12 the following day. But that works for me because I'm full, and I have sometimes a snack in the middle of that and then dinner about 6 o'clock. And then from there, if I haven't had an afternoon snack, but I need a dinner snack after dinner, then I do that. So that in somebody's mind is a lot of freeing up of three meals and, you know, a lot of extra groceries that you don't need. And keto does not need to be expensive. I don't know. I know some people go all organic, and that if you can afford to do that, that's great. But if you can't, that doesn't mean you can't be on keto. It just means that you're gonna build up to it. The way I look at keto is I would rather spend my money on groceries and getting healthy and losing weight than spend it at going to the doctor and giving it to him. So that's my logic toward it. You guys can do whatever you want. And also, keto is going to help you if you are on any kind of medications. If you take this for a long enough time, your doctor may take you off of those medications. And if he takes you off those medications, you don't have to spend that money anymore. So, you know, it's all in how you look at things. So if you think it's too expensive, expand on some of the other things that you're doing. If you're going to a coffee shop and getting coffee once or twice a day, how much is that costing you? You know, so justify your numbers, you know, make it real. But if you want to do something bad enough, we usually find a way to do it, don't we? And if we're getting benefits from it and we're losing weight from it, we're losing inches from it, would you tell me that you would not do that? Would you not spend a little extra money to do that to make you feel better? I think you would. I am, but I'm not spending a ton of money. That's not what I'm saying. I'm just saying that you need to, you know, keep your priorities straight. And the next thing I would probably say would be to pre-plan. If you are dining out, find out where you're going and get some information, and make sure that you're, you know, not going in blind, because we all dine out, and it is, you know, it's a way of the world, and we get busy, so we have to sometimes go through fast foods. So you can look up different ways to, you know, maybe pre-plan that your kids have got soccer games or basketball games, and you know that you got like 15 minutes in between, and you don't know what you're going to do to eat, and you don't have time to make a recipe, or you didn't have time this morning to, you know, make enough for dinner time too. So just pre-plan, just look, Google, use Google a lot. I do. And, you know, look up keto friendly fast foods or, you know, I don't know, just, you know, make sure that you're eating, your fast food hamburgers. My hair's crazy today. Make sure that you're doing like keto friendly. You can go to Wendy's and get a Baconator, you know, with just lettuce and the meat and the cheese. And there's so many things you can do. So just pre-plan that way. Make sure, again, that you're getting fluids. And, you know, if you're dealing, if you're worried about the keto flus, just coming off of sugars and flours, make sure that you're taking magnesium and you're taking Himalayan sea salt. Pink Himalayan sea salt is your best friend. And potassium if you start getting like leg cramps. And a lot of those things and drinking a lot of fluids will keep your electrolytes up so that you don't have that, hopefully. And if you do that, maybe you have helped it in some form or fashion from being absolutely, you know, 10 times worse than maybe it would have been. The next thing I would say is sit back and enjoy the ride. I know we get stressed out, but you've got to sit back and enjoy the ride. The next thing I would say is take a before picture of your side, your back, your front, and your other side. Take it in tight clothes. I mean, have this memory. This is why you're doing it. And I would say, you know, if at your halfway mark, maybe take another picture and then take your final picture. And the next thing I would say is measure. Be sure to measure because the scale isn't always our friend and it's not always nice. But if you measure and you check that once a month, now those are the true feelings. And the next thing I would say is if you want to check to see if you're in ketosis, get yourself some strips. There's many different products you can, you know, you can prick your blood. You can, I think there's a one that you test your saliva. There's one that you pee on. You know, so it's a personal choice. Do your research on that. But if you want to make sure that you're in ketosis, and then the next thing I would say is get the carb app. The Carb Manager app. That is so important. And I'll put a link down below for you to get yours if you don't know what I'm talking about, because that is so, so important to keep track of all your macros every day. If you don't keep track of it, you don't know where you are. You don't know if you're losing or gaining. You don't know how much food you've eaten. You don't know how much fat you've eaten. You don't know how many proteins you've eaten. And it's just a way to just be able to do it easy. It keeps track of all of that when you put it in. It keeps track of all your recipes that you have. You can scan foods that you eat on a daily basis so you don't have to put it in every time again. Keeps track of all your water, keeps track of all your exercise. If you have a Fitbit, it'll interlink to that so you can keep track of all your steps and keep track of all your calories. So just, you know, if you want to be successful with keto, just, you know, you just have to take a few steps. And when you take those steps, it's so worth it. I promise you, it's so worth it. So with that said, those would be the top things that I would do getting started with keto. And I hope that helps. I love you guys. And if you're not subscribed to me, please do. I'd love to have you as a subscriber. Click the bell up above so you never miss one of my videos. And I look forward to tomorrow, day 18 of the 30 days on keto. I'm going to be on a lot longer than 30 days because I have 80 some pounds to lose. But let me know if you want it longer than 30 days and maybe I'll change my mind. All right, guys, I love each and every one of you. I'm so glad you're here with me, and I will see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.